Look at Aaron. It's Aaron.
Yeah. teaching us and helping you to try and tell them. So thank you.
Alright, guys, they told me to make a speech for them, so I actually got out a speech. A couple of my fellow captains here said to keep it short and sweet, but it's just going to be sweet. it wouldn't be a glowing my speech for a sports team without thanking the supporters. And let's be honest, this is slim. Pretty much every supporter is also a parent or relative of some sort. Thank you for your sacrifices and donations of money, of time, of effort. Thank you for so many other things, for bringing us to practices, meets, and to events, for taking time out of your day to time and work a snack bar, for bringing us breakfast for every morning practice, for making every summer feel that they had a personal supporter other than their own family, for being there for us when we did well and even more so when we didn't, for all of your support inside and outside the blue. It's not easy being there for a bunch of teenagers who take everything for granted. Without you, this team wouldn't exist, and this team would not have gone as well as it did. A special, special thank you to a couple of parents as well. Mrs. Ho, obviously, for being our team mom. Mr. Seven, for waking up for practices at 5 on a weekday and 8 on a weekend to help us in the gym and being there at every meet for recovery questions. Mrs. Ong and a lot of other parents I can't remember right now who doubled up on morning practice breakfast. Mr. David, for being my biggest fan and cheerleader every day. And my own parents, for being the base on which all of my achievements and success will always be based on. Okay. There's a lot more, sorry guys. Okay, Rachel, this one's for you. Rachel is the kind of person who can only be described as cheerful and bubbly. No matter what happened, as long as she had her coffee, she was somehow constantly delightfully happy all the time. She's the kind of person who can both criticize you and make you feel like you did a great job at the same time. Nobody I have ever met blended firmness and kindness in so perfect a manner. Yet behind her kind exterior, there hides a fierce competitiveness and a fierce protectiveness of her athletes that bled into each and every one of us. She fought for us so hard that we had no option but to fight just as hard for ourselves. That fiercely quiet tenacity drove us as much as Danny's hope and belief. As a coach, her role is simply astonishing. One simply needs to look at the time drops and e-balls by long-distance runners to understand how clearly she is not in draw. Rachel made her swim fun, almost enjoyable, which is hard in and of itself. And she was more than my coach at times. She was a cheerleader, a critic, a friend, and an inspiration. She was kind, caring, and compassionate, and all the other ways in the world we are our team. She was a perfect mother to this family of swimmers. It's easy, as swimmers, to get caught up in the numbers, the multiplication of ourselves, in those seconds. Coaches like Rachel, and teams like this, will always be there to remind us of the importance. Science will tell you that we are all there to start this team. Getting to know Rachel, let us show you that some of us just have a little more than the rest of us. The greatest lesson I learned from Rachel is that it's hard to feel sad and hope more when you have a heart. Lifetimes are measured not in years, but in memories. Suffice it to say that my life would be much shorter without this team. What I'll remember about high school is not the classes I took, the teachers I had, or even the many incredible things I saw and experienced. It will be this team where I belong. Coach Danny made us a team where swimming on, we're fighting for, and most importantly, a swimmer to be proud of. I'm proud to be a swimmer, always, but I'm even more proud to say that I swim for the world. The most valuable thing in the world is our race, and with this team, that is priceless, and there is nothing in this world that I would trade for that. I think the single greatest moment of my career was not winning the U-153. Yes, it was a constrained and pure joy, but no, not my greatest moment. No, my greatest moment came a few seconds later, when I was struggling at my 14 years of swimming, almost 15 now, sharing that joy with someone who deserved it far more than me, who was simple hugging me. A hug was my greatest joy, and it speaks volumes about the person on the other side of that hug that was so much. Thank you for making this team of brothers and sisters and bringing us to this point. Thank you for pushing us harder every day. Thank you for making me not just just the story, but the person I actually am. Thank you for being kind to me. A good motivator, a better coach, and a best friend. It's a privilege to swim for you, and a greater privilege to know you. All right, okay, one more. One last thank you and goodbye. The team. I tried for so long to write the right words, but it always came out wrong. But like swimming, sometimes it's just the best you can do. So here goes. It's a bittersweet day for me. It suddenly struck me that I might never see some of you ever again. The people I considered my brothers and sisters might one day be strangers again. Yes, today we celebrate the meets we won, the times we achieved, the people we met. But today also marks the shift. The shift from experienced reality to a fading, fleeting memory. I think I'll just say this. I speak for all the seniors, all of us leaving soon for new adventures. Wherever you go, no matter how much time and distance separates us, you'll never walk alone. I'll always be cheering for you from the edge of the pool. It is not possible for me to express in words the limitless joy you have brought to my heart. They say that love is when home is a person and not a place, and I've never felt more at home than with this team. I owe an unpayable debt for that. This team is, for right now, my everything. My homecoming, my prom, and my ball day were all swimmers. My first trip from My first true friends in high school were swimmers. The truth is, my family does not end with my blood relatives. It ends here. Here was a place of first for me. Obviously, there are the first league wins, first championships, first states, first road trip to Disney, first time beating Amador. But there are other, more important firsts too. First relationships, first time someone cried on my shoulder, the first time I cried on someone else's shoulder. First lifelong friends, first place to belong no matter what. And the first time it will hurt to my very core to say goodbye. All right, guys, they told me to make a speech for them, so I actually wrote out a speech. A couple of my fellow captains here said to keep it short and sweet, but this is just gonna be sweet. First, it wouldn't be a going away speech for a sports team without thanking the supporters. And let's be honest, this is swim. Pretty much every support is also a parent or relative of some sort. Thank you for your sacrifices and donations of money, of time, of effort.